Good evening and welcome to the Folk O'Clock Show. Folk O'Clock Show number 61, according to my little notebook here. I like to try and be organised. Let me just rearrange myself, dropping everything. I hope you are all well. We've got a great lineup this evening. 2 hours. We try and stick to 2 hours. We rarely ever achieve it.
I wonder why.
Oh, I thought they were going to be quiet in the green room. No,
yeah,
exactly. Because I apparently the lady who doesn't shut up tells me I talk too much.
Really do.
Anyway, where was I? We've got a great show lined up this evening. We've got 10 acts this evening. We've got 3 live acts.
Hooray!
Are you there, Doris, in the green room? Woo! From the green room.
Yeah, I'm here.
We've got 3 live acts. 2 in the studio. We got 1 all the way from Germany via Zoom. We've got 4 recordings from local clubs, me on my travels. And we've got 3 special recordings from IveTech Media over in the posh end of Fleet. I never knew whether I'm looking at the right bit of the screen here. So if it look like I'm looking out the road, it doesn't matter, of course. It's a live show. So we've got 10 acts all lined up. Fantastic. A great evening ahead of us. Sally Brooke, I do believe you're with us all the way from California. First in tonight. First in tonight, Sally, to get a front seat.
Yeah.
That's what it is, to get a front seat.
Mosh pit.
All make your way down to the front. Grab a mosh pit. Folk O'Clock mosh pit. Can you imagine it?
Yeah, just one person.
Do you know, I've been distracted now. I went to see From the Jam, so it wasn't... It was Bruce Foxton, not... Come on. The Jam.
Foxton, that's an estate agent.
No, he's the bass player. No, who's the main singer? Come
I
on.
Don't
I can't think.
Know.
John will know. Flipping A. Anyway, we went to see it, and there was a mosh pit, and I thought, right, I'm in. And I'd gone straight from work, and I had a suit on, shirt, tie, the whole lot. By the end of the evening, I'd thrown the shirt... I still had my jacket on. I'd thrown the shirt away, because it was just... covered in sweat, and every time somebody got knocked over or fell over in the mosh pit, everyone stopped and picked up because we're all a bit sensible now. It was good. It was very, very civilised. Anyway, a slight distraction there. What's happening? Right, it's filling up. Everybody's in. Who else have we got in the house? Jutta is with us.
Hey.
Doris, where's Jutta from? No, I know that, but a little bit more accurate than that.
Heavenberg.
Cool.
That
helps.
That helps a lot.
Is that
45 minutes from my home?
Oh, not too far. That's what I'm asking. How far from you? Okay, perfect. Right. Who else have we got in the house? Doris, of course. Annie Lendon. Good evening, Annie. Annie's with us. We've got Michael Tuffery's watching.
Hi, Mike.
Come back to Michael. Dave Hunter's with us.
Oh,
fantastic.
Dave Hunter. Hello, Dave.
Dave Edgington, all the way from Lanzarote. It's a truly international audience.
Oh.
It makes me smile to think there's people out there.
Yeah.
Who are going to listen to our music. They've got nothing better to do than tune into the Folk O'Clock Show.
They don't know that COVID's over.
But even though COVID's over, it still keep coming back. But it is very much appreciated. And I'm still listening to the Bass and Taylor album. David Edgington, I'm still listening to the album. It's a brilliant album. Anyway, we're going to quickly say hello to John Ive. He isn't expecting it because he's playing with his phone. if you could have seen, I should have gone to video first because he jumped when I said we're going to. I'm not sure what he's looking at on his phone, but he definitely jumped.
He's deleted it.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Quickly turned it off. Right, John, I'm just going to come across and say hello, John.
Good evening, Joe.
Hey, how are you doing?
It's raining over here, Joe. Is it raining with you?
No, that's because you've got posh gardens on the other side of Fleet and you need the grass to be good. Right,
Everyone into the studio. How are you?
We're good.
We're good.
Excellent. Thanks, John. Okay, so we're going to have our first act of the season. Have I missed it? You know when you start an event and you're supposed to do all the... It's not caretaking, is it? What is it? You're the chairman of the board.
I don't know what you're talking about.
You know, where's the toilets and fire alarm and...
Oh, yeah.
Exit. Where's
drinks.
The exit?
The drinks are free.
Yeah.
The drinks are free and...
Drinks.
Events of like landing on water.
We've still got the leftovers of the King's Ginger from the World Tour of Scotland.
Lovely.
We've got that. We've got dirty snacking. I bought hot crisps. Steve Donnelly brought cheesy balls.
I was supposed to say that.
Oh, you?
Hot cheesy balls.
You've got to eat them.
Hot cheesy balls.
Hot they are hot cheesy balls. Exactly. Right. And we got scratchings and all sorts of stuff. We're going to listen to our first act this evening. Now, this was from Ready Folk. I'd never seen these guys before, called The Berries. Anyone heard of The Berries?
No.
They were good. So I thought, right, I'll record them. And they're going to sing a song called Man of British Weather. Anybody know this? Man of British Weather?
No.
Written by Mark Stevenson in 1989.
No, we're still a no.
So, apart from me, because I've listened to it, because I recorded it, and I thought it was really good. It's new to everybody in the studio here this evening. In a way, I'm hoping it's new to you, because you'll enjoy it for the first time. So, housekeeping. Somebody's replied and said housekeeping.
Housekeeping.
I can't... Conor Reynolds. He's so...
Conor,
your son.
Your son
Conor's online with us. And we're going to hear from Conor in a bit anyway.
Like Conor.
So, let's have some... I don't know whether you get it on your phones or your devices now. Well, you know, you can click a like or a heart and little things appear on the screen. I don't know if it still does it. But if it does, let's have some love and likes.
I don't get that on my device.
For the Lynn doesn't get it on her. It's not that. Stop it. It's not nine o'clock yet. Right. The Berries singing Man of British Weather by Mark Stevenson, 1989. British Weather, the Berries. It's great having it. What's good about a live show, it's real time and people are filling in the notes. That's why I can wing it, because Anna Bass is in for the lovely Bob and Jill. She hasn't seen them for ages. Bob Anna Bass from Great Bardfield. Bass and Taylor. Good evening, Anna. Good evening, Jean and John. Thanks for joining us. The Lady of Loch Lochy is in the house. Yay, fantastic. Mum's in with us. Hi, Mum. How are you doing? Mum's dancing. She's posting those funny... Alison Humphrey's parish notices. See, I think Alison's a bit of a filthy one, I think.
Do you?
I think she goes to church for all the wrong reasons. Yeah.
Do you think
Alison,
so?
Yeah. Yeah. And she's earlier than... It's not 9 o'clock. I can't say things like that. Alison, I do apologise. I don't really. Alison, thank you for joining us. We must get her back on the show.
I like Alison a lot.
Yeah, Alison, she's talented. She's good. She's fun. Yeah. Right, Michael Tuffery. Yeah, brilliant. Man of British weather. It had a bit of a...
Yeah.
A bit of something to it. I enjoyed that. Thank you to the berries. Even though I did try and contact them. I messaged them privately on Lynn's yawning already.
Sorry.
I messaged them privately on Facebook to say, look, I've recorded you. Do you mind if I play it? And, well, I got no response, so I played it anyway.
Yeah.
You think, well, I'd rather plead for forgiveness.
Send them a check.
Send them a check.
No, exactly. It's all good publicity. Alison Humphrey says, eek, I'm sure. Hi, Joe, Michael, Dada. I had meant to go into the nightclub to see Bob and Jill, but something diverted. Ah, yes, it was Ready Folk, of course. Right. Our second act this evening is... Ah, Conor Reynolds is with us. Now, I had the absolute pleasure of... I'm saying this not just to talk rubbish, but I don't know what John's doing in the green room.
I don't know what he's doing.
But I went on Sunday to see and record the new Roots music event. So every year, for 23 years, they invite, I think it's 18 to 24-year-olds, and they basically all perform. And it's not a competition where somebody wins, but it's an event that is used to record these people and then... make that information available to all the local folk clubs so that they can show an interest in getting them into their clubs.
Brilliant.
Really, really good. I think that's the basic gist of it. Connor, correct me if I'm wrong. It was Tom Evans who asked me could I fill in for him because he couldn't go and record it. So I was a little bit reluctant because it was on a Sunday and it's family time. I'm chuffed a bit that I went. The standard and the people were lovely. It was really good. So if you hear about new routes... you definitely should give it a look and listen. Right. Conor Reynolds was one of those artists. And, of course, we've had him on the FolkOclock Show a couple of months ago and found out that he's Lynn's illegitimate son.
Yeah, he is. Yeah. He's very good.
How you didn't realise.
I know, no. But you can tell because he's so talented.
And he plays a squeezy box. Yeah, I think he's great. And this video, and I'm OK to introduce this one, aren't I, John? We are. I'll get a thumbs up from John. This one was recorded over at IveTech Media. OK, so, Connor, I'm glad you're with us, and I'm glad you created a video so that we can share it with everybody. This is called Keep the Shade. Let's have some love and likes for the very talented Mr. Connor Reynolds. We'll be right back. Conor Reynolds.
Oh, there he is. Class. My boy.
Yeah. Bit of class.
Conor, we'll have to get you back. In fact, I'm hoping, Conor, that I'm going to get permission to play the videos that I recorded on Sunday of these young artists, over a period of time. Clearly, and you've had your turn, Conor, so it won't be you. Now, Conor mentioned it in the notes, but for anybody who didn't see Conor's comment, he's just recorded his first EP yesterday.
Yay!
Woohoo! Go on. And keep up the singing, Conor, because you play a lovely squeeze box, but I think you've got a good voice as well.
Yes.
I like the singing as well. Right, Melanie Mulholland is watching. Good evening, Melanie. Thanks for joining us.
What a great name that is, Melanie Mulholland.
She's a lovely lady. She goes all over the world. She takes ace pictures and makes me jealous for not being on holiday. Right, we've got an interesting little bit of information from Colin Bailey. Bob Berry, who was the Berries, the first act this evening. It was Bob Berry's mum who wrote, "I wandered by a brookside," as recorded by Firport Convention.
Wow.
Whoa. Woohoo! Colin Bailey of the Bailey Beat. He knows stuff. And we're going to hear from Colin later. Right. How good was that? Should we mention CDs yet? What's the time? We're going to do good for time. I always say that and then I talk too much. What are we going to mention?
Yeah. No.
Nobody noticed.
No.
Exactly. I've got fluff on my jumper. Now I think we're going to go to the... I was just going to say, the quiz. The world famous FolkOclock free quiz. And oh, actually, John Tanner, that bottle there.
I know. It's
that's
got
for
my
you
name
to
on
take
it.
Away.
It's got my name on it. I know.
I did pay attention to your comment earlier today to pick up my bottle of
that was
his.
An additional incentive.
I checked and we owe you one. Right. We're going to go across to IveTech Media to the fabulously talented, but very generous, Mr. John Ive. Everybody goes over there and uses his studio and everything. So, it's, you know, all for a good cause, charity. And John can remind you of it before we do the quiz. John, let's have the quiz. I'm not pressing the right buttons here.
You're on.
Thanks, Joe. And don't adjust your sets. It's raining over in this part of Fleet, so that's what's happening. It's not a problem with static on the lines. This is very wet Fleet, or at least Avondale Road in Fleet. So, Joe, just a point of order. If I understand correctly, and Conor will correct us in the notes if I've got it wrong, but I think he plays a diatonic button accordion, not a squeeze box. So there you have it.
But John, I'm half right. He squeezes the bloody thing. Of course it's a squeeze box. You squeeze it.
Zero marks for that. But anyway, fantastic musician. And if I understand correctly, he writes his own songs and he plays a lot of traditional folk songs. And that was a very good example that he was playing there. So, onto the quiz, and the reason it's white raining in this part of Fleet was I get the impression we've had a lot of rain recently. Don't you feel we've had a lot of rain? Joe was talking about it the other day and he said, why don't we have a quiz that's themed around rain? And I thought, well, why not? And I also thought this week or this show, I'd make it very easy because I get the impression that some of you are a little bit reluctant to participate because I make them too hard. So I think this one's going to be really easy and it's themed around rain. Five questions as always. And the one who gets the most questions right, or if you all get them right, we'll choose a winner using the science, as I'm sure someone will say later on, and we'll choose a winner from those who got all the questions right. So the key is, First thing, let me get rid of some rain magically. There we go. Rain has gone. And yes, so onto the quiz. The key is that I'm going to give you a song, and I need the name of the person who primarily made it famous or is associated with that song. It'll all become clear as we move into question number one. Fire and Rain. Was that performed and possibly written by Paul Simon, James Taylor, or John Denver? Now, because there are five questions, why don't you open the comments box now and put the answer to this one in that, and you can build up your answers so you don't forget what the first few questions were. So I want all your answers in a single comments box, and I'll be looking at them over the next one or two songs to see who's the winner. But this first question is Fire and Rain. Is it Paul Simon, James Taylor, or John Denver? Question two. The theme about rain continues. Purple Rain. Is that Prince, Jimi Hendrix, or Deep Purple? Purple Rain, Prince, Jimi Hendrix, Deep Purple. Get those answers in your comments box before we go on to question number three. Set Fire to the Rain. Joni Mitchell, Alicia Keys, or Adele? Was Set Fire to the Rain made famous primarily by Joni Mitchell, Alicia Keys, or Adele? That's question number three. Question number four. A Hard Rain's Gonna Fall. That could have been Bruce Springsteen, it could have been Bob Dylan, or it could have been Neil Young. Which one was it? A Hard Rain's Gonna Fall, Bruce Springsteen, Bob Dylan, or Neil Young? And our final question tonight, A Kiss in the Rain. And some popular guitarist singers here with John Renbourn, Bert Jansch, and Ralph McTell. A Kiss in the Rain, was it John Renbourn, Bert Jansch, or Ralph McTell? Just in case you missed any, very quickly, Fire and Rain, was it Paul Simon, James Taylor, or John Denver? Purple Rain, Prince, Jimi Hendrix, or Deep Purple? Set Fire to the Rain, Joni Mitchell, Alicia Keys, or Adele? A Hard Rain's Are Gonna Fall, Bruce Springsteen, Bob Dylan, or Neil Young? And finally, A Kiss in the Rain, with John Renbourn, or Bert Jansch, or Ralph McTell? So those are your five questions tonight. They are easy, aren't they? Tell me they're easy. I'm looking forward to lots of answers. Five answers in the comments box. One or two songs for you to, for me to add them all up and find out the totals. And then I'll come back to you and give you both the answers and tonight's winner. Back to you, Joe.
Unmute the microphone. I nearly did it. Just at the last set, I thought, oh, microphone. Yeah, so I got my little sign from Mad Mandy, Mandy Shorer. Good evening, Mandy. I don't think you're with us, but there you go. You've had a mention. Anna Bass says, anything like that is a squeeze box. I agree, Anna Bass. And, in fairness, Conor Reynolds says, melodeon, diatonic button accordion, squeeze box, contraption, whatever you like. There you go.
There you go.
It's all right, John.
Yes.
Come on.
We're all right.
Right. Jan Moncrief was right off the bat there with those answers. Flipping heck, I might have to go back to Scotland.
Who's she put for the last?
Don't take, because we didn't know the last one, Jan. We got all of them except the last one. Yeah. We didn't know. Lynn's looking and she might just say it.
I won't say it.
The Gillies are in the house. Good evening, the Gillies. And we're going to hear from the Gillies later. Is it Gillies? It must be Gillies.
Gillies.
Gillies, yeah. Tell me if I've got it wrong. Super. Right. Yeah, good quiz. Ah, John Quinn, he's a ringer as well. Let me have a look at his answers. I think we're going to have to put it in a hat, John.
Yeah.
Or it's going to be a very expensive evening.
Yeah. Oh, look.
Jan says, come back. I will. Scotland was beautiful. Right. We've had two acts so far. Two, one, two. We are on to it. I think he's ready. He's destroying he's destroying things. And I think this is we're gonna hear from John Tanner live in the studio. I think you've been here once before. Been here twice before, but you've been on the live on the show, haven't you? Yeah. I think this guy's really talented. He's very modest. And he has a but I'm not sure how to describe it, but he has a sort of a slightly offbeat delivery. I don't know.
I'm not good at keeping time. That's the thing.
Yeah, but it's the way you do it's really good, and I don't know. You know,
that's how you should do it.
It's really good. It's really good. I like it, and I heard John for the first time in 2017 or 18. Boots of Spanish Leather at the Anchor Folk Club. I was a big fan from that moment on. Anyway, the mighty John Quinn is in the house. Lynn sticking her fingers down her mouth.
I'll pay you, don't
Conor Reynolds is a big fan too. Conor knows his stuff. Yeah, absolutely. Michael Tuffery, oh, they've all got answers tonight, John. Yeah. John, you're going to have to do your work. We're going to hear from John Tanner. I'm delighted you came back, John. Introduce yourself, although I've done half a job. And a couple of songs, please. Let's have some love and likes, bearing in mind he will see the comments, for the fabulously talented Mr. John Tanner.
That's very
Yay. Kind. Hey! Come on, John.
Thank you for inviting me back, even though, you know, after the last time and the police and all the rest of it. This first song is Old Bones by Jez Lowe. When I was young, my father said to me, he said, never take advice when it comes for free. Cause you know all the riches of the golden kind without riches of your peace of mind. He said, you won't make old bones, you won't make old bones, you won't make old bones, you'll see. The old men sit and curse time slipping sand, I sit and I curse the time upon my hand. As the north wind blows like the song of the sea, the song it carries comes plain to me and says, you won't make old bone, you won't make old bone, you won't make old bones, you'll see. Some folks make remark, my furrows and frowns. We say the only way to leg up is when they turn you down. Now everybody gives the same advice, they say, don't sign up for a soldier's life, or you won't make old shoes, you won't make old bones, you won't make old bones, you'll see. So I went to the army, like everyone told me to do, told me to do. They said, we'd love to make a soldier out of you. But before I put my name on the line, my father's words came to me in time and said, you won't make old bone, you won't make old bone, you won't make old bones, you'll see. Your guns and your drums are not for the likes of me, the likes of me. Though my future it might be bleaker than bleak can be. Cause you talk of the many, owing much to the few, when all I wanted was a job to do. They said, you won't make old bones, you won't make old bones, you won't make old bones, you'll see. So you people in power and position, I tell you beware, tell you beware. Your facts and your figures that tell you what, when and where. Cause your facts and your figures are the likes of me, so don't try to tell me how my life should be. Or you won't make old bone, you won't make old bone, you won't make old bones, you'll see. Well, a lot of us did, didn't we, actually? Yeah. So I got a list here. If only I had my glasses on, I'd have to read it.
One more. No more. And this second song is by Steve Tilson, who specialises in taking other people's old material and rehashing it in a very, very professional way, I have to say. You've got to imagine that I'm a young virgin. Female virgin. This is the Fisher Lad of Whitby. He was a fisher lad, and when we came to shore, he always steered to me to greet me at my door. He knew that I loved him well, as anyone could see. Ah, but I was fain when he came courting me. So on one lovely morning, one morning in May, he took me in his fishing boat out upon the bay, and he told me of his love as we wallowed with the tide, and before the month was over, I would be his bride. And the ships come sailing in, and the ships they sail away, and the fishermen they sing their songs out on Whitby Bay, and the fishermen they haul their nets. How happy I would be living with my fisher lad down beside the sea. Now that very afternoon, the press gang combed the lanes. They dragged him to a man of war, bound by iron chains. Irons on his hands, and irons on his feet, and they carried him aboard, fighting the fleet. Ships come sailing in, and the ships they sail away, and the fishermen they sing their songs out on Whitby Bay, and the fishermen they haul, and that's how happy I would be living with my fisher lad down beside the sea. Now my father often talks the perils of the main. My mother says she hopes he will come back again, but I know he never will, for in my dreams I see his body lying below the bottom of the sea. And the ships come sailing in, and the ships they sail away, and the fishermen they sing their songs out on Whitby Bay, and the fishermen they haul, and that's how happy I would be living with my fisher lad down beside the sea. When the house is still and everyone's asleep, I sit upon my bed and most steadily I weep. Think of my true love, the bottom of the sea, for he never, never more will come again to me. Ships come sailing in, and the ships they sail away, and the fishermen they sing their songs out on Whitby Bay, and the fishermen they haul, and that's how happy I would be living with my fisher lad down beside the sea. Out of Whitby. Thank you. Yes. Thank you very much.
That was absolutely brilliant. Lovely,
they're
John.
Throwing shoes at me halfway.
Right. As you probably noticed during that broadcast, there was a slight noise. And thank you very much, Michael, for suggesting that maybe I'd fallen over. No, I did not.
Get drunk.
I am driving tonight. So that particular little pleasure will have to wait until I go home, amongst others. Anyway, so unfortunately we've had to fire Joe McBurney for literally dropping a pair of shoes on us. Here's one of the said shoes, obviously some cheap stuff from Italy. Whatever his name is, Steve.
Got
a box on the head.
I'm all right.
I'm all right. So while I'm sitting here, while we leave Joe to sulk out in the corner outside, I've got the pleasure of introducing the next song, the next video, because it is the wonderful person that was John Stannard, and this was one of his last songs, and I think the last thing you recorded him doing, wasn't it? And it's a great song, and I know you all love it, and it's called Shades of Grey.
Fantastic.
There's a small box in my pocket and a question in my head. There's an aching in my heart and a space here in my bed. Oh, how I wish I'd found myself a way to stay. But yes, that was one too many shades of grey. I can't help thinking, as lovers often do, someone else out there, or is there only you? Is there just one question, or a million on the way? Which one was the one that was one too many shades of grey? We both set out for a paradise at last. When we got there, all they said was, don't walk on the grass. The way around was too long, so we did it anyway. And that was the one that was too many shades of grey. Well, I know you have been broken, I know you had been hurt. I know that you'd been pushed around and face down in the dirt. I did my best to mend you, but did I just get in the way? Was one too many shades of grey. Well, everyone has baggage, you know I have mine too. Did you ever stop to think it wasn't all about you? Too much compromise, you lose the truth along the way. That's when you find there's one too many shades of grey. Where yesterday came, you know, tomorrow went. The more that we put in, it seemed, the more we were spent. Maybe there was one more thing we should have done today, but I guess that was one too many shades of grey. You said you'd reached the part that others couldn't reach. You told me that those who can't end up trying to teach. I forgot how to listen, it didn't matter anyway. What you had to say was one too many shades of grey. Well, there's a bar around the corner, full of hearts like mine. Bruised and battered, self-absorbed and wallowing in brine. Looking for a reason to find somewhere else to stay. But I guess that was one too many shades of grey. You said you'd climb the mountain, if that was what I'd want. You'd even read the scripture, but you couldn't read the fonts. You could have bought a bigger print, or just sat down to pray. But I guess that was one too many shades of grey. You know yesterday's prophets telling yesterday's news. But I switched off my radio in 1962, and the last thing I heard, it's just as true today. Who said there was one too many shades of grey? Well, I took you to my soul, I showed you my disgrace. Then you took me to your special hidden place. Maybe we revealed a little too much on the way. And I guess that was one too many shades of grey. You know you arrived a stranger, you left more than a friend. It doesn't stop me wanting you, I'm just a man in the end. Call it right or wrong, it's just a point of view along the way. And I guess that was one too many shades of grey. Am I being churlish, or is it common sense to think the small box in my pocket would do for someone else? She wouldn't have to know that it was nearly yours today. But I guess that was one too many shades of grey. Well, Abigail is waiting, she remembers me now. Maybe I should go to her and forget about our vow. My sheets are cold, maybe it's time for me to stray. Forget that I was somehow hung up on two shades of grey. There is always one too many shades of grey.
Yeah. Go on. John C. I'm back. John C. Stannard. Yeah, that was the... I don't know if it was actually the last one he wrote, but I remember him coming to the windmill and he'd been writing it that day and he had it on a piece of paper. And I thought, quick, I'm going to record this, and I'm very pleased that I did. We've had it a couple of times on the show, but it's such a good song. Yeah, sadly missed. I'll give you a hug later, darling.
Okay.
Canberra.
Something to look forward to.
Can't wait.
Just keep that one.
No job.
keep that one. Well, no, because you must miss him.
Yeah,
I mean, in a nice way, not in a sexy way. I mean, a nice way. Flipping air.
Still talking about, please.
So we've started the dirty snacking. We've got lime and coriander chutney poppadoms. Pompadoms. Anyway, I just noticed Cam Brown is in the house. Good evening, Cameron. Is on Hersham. It's not called a folk club. Hersham
Live Music.
Live Music Club, which is brilliant. It's really well.
Absolutely, top notch.
Stevie Boy Donnelly was ranting about it. Yeah, it's a brilliant place. In fact, John, I went to see you there.
I've been there a few times, yeah.
Yeah, I recorded you there.
Yeah.
Was in the audience. So Cam Brown, I think, Cameron, correct me if I'm wrong, I think it might be next Tuesday night. Is it next Tuesday? Soon, Cameron.
I can tell you because it's in my diet.
If you're still with us, Cameron, put the date in there, because for anyone who's not been to Hersham, you should check it out. It is very good. Get there early because the parking's not that great.
It's not. You end up having to park up near the pub.
Yeah, exactly. But you'll get parking. For the 2nd of May, Cameron Brown at Hersham on. He sings a funny song, Cameron. He always sings the sort of the funny, dirty ones, doesn't he?
I think he's brilliant.
Yeah, brilliant.
Absolutely brilliant.
Sister Josephine's my favourite because I went to a convent school as a child and it's been like a fetish ever since. So I particularly like that one.
That says a lot.
To a Catholic school.
And I apologise for the shoes falling out of the studio roof. It fell on Steve Donnelly.
I'm okay. I'm still okay. Chairman Gobblers.
He's the big actor. He's the final big act for this evening.
He's going to be singing falsetto. Now.
We nearly knocked him out. It's time to find out who is this week's... He's waiting ever so patiently in the wings. Who is this week's winner of the world-famous Folk O'Clock quiz? Come in, Mr. John Ive.
Thanks, Joe. Before I get on to the quiz, I just want to say a few words about John C. Stannard, because I've had quite a few people who played with him come through the studio doing recordings. Lynne, of course, you're one of them. And everybody spoke so highly of John C. Stannard. And I just kind of regret that I was too late on the scene to have actually met him. But I'm pleased to have had the sort of first-person account of many of his friends. And Joe, you're right, he has been sorely missed.
So, let's move on to the quiz, and we do have a winner.
But before we get to the winner, let's just take a quick look at the answers. Not many of you actually answered in writing this time, but you answered them in your head. So just to check whether or not you got them right,
let's go through them.
Fire and Rain was, of course, James Taylor. And that came from the great album, Sweet Baby James. Purple Rain should have been obvious, but that's from Prince, from the album of the same name. Set Fire to the Rain was Adele. Some of you thought it was Alicia Keys. But definitely from the album Adele 2021. Then number four, A Hard Rain's Gonna Fall. I thought that was a title that sounded like it could have come from Springsteen. But of course it actually came from Bob Dylan. And came from the album The Free Wheeling, Bob Dylan. And then finally, A Kiss in the Rain was Ralph Tell. I've been listening to this album recently. Somewhere down the road, great album. That's where A Kiss in the Rain came from, performed by Ralph Tell.
So those are your answers.
And first of all, we give credit to John Quinn and Tuffery, Jan McCroof was also there as well, but had one answer wrong. John Quinn, Michael Tuffery. So I'm sure Lynne will be using the science site, but I used it here and consulted with our dog Lottie, who's just down by the side there. And choosing between John Quinn and Michael Tuffery.
Lottie, you'll be pleased to know Michael chose you.
Michael Tuffery is pure coincidence, I think he's on next, that is an absolute coincidence because he is a very worthy winner. Michael Tuffery, well done, congratulations.
You're the winner of tonight's music quiz.
Back to you, Joe.
Yay. Michael Tuffery, well done, Michael. Thank you very much, John. Excellent quiz. Yeah, we got four. We didn't get the fifth one. Well, we did when we saw everybody else's answer. John Tanner started to relax now that he's done his set. He can relax. He's having a drink because the drinks are free, and he's on the dirty snacking, but he was a bit torn between Steve's cheesy balls and my sweet nuts. But he... or Lynne's poppadoms. Anyway, let me write this down. Michael Tuffery.
Well, if he's coming Friday, quiz, I could take that for him.
Oh, you'll have to plug that when you do the raffle. You have to give it a mention. That was the other thing I was trying to think of. Fabulous. Thank you, John. John's got some John Lennon glasses now. He's got glasses on.
Oh my God.
Flipping neck. And did you notice, everybody, I didn't mention the shirt? Because actually, I think this shirt's quite nice. I'm only horrible when they're rubbish. My brother Andy's watching. Andy, good evening. Thanks for joining us. Diane Tassie's with us. Good evening, Diane. Sally Brooks still with Colin, still with May Mills is watching. May, hello. I hope you're well. Right, we're going to have our next act this evening, act number five, which means we're halfway and it's only 8:48.
Oh, you'll have to talk a bit more, Joe.
I normally get told off for talking.
I can't, can it?
Yeah, and I apologise for the shoes fell out the roof right on Steve. Terrible. It's a first.
He's repeating himself now.
Pardon?
Nurse.
Okay. As John said, we're going to hear from Michael Tuffery now. We were over at the Boars Bridge Sessions at the end of last month, because it's on the last Friday of the month. Lynne is going to mention it when she does the raffle, which clearly means Sam White's not with it. In fact, he's at the bullet. He's been fired. We've sacked him.
Yeah, we don't know who he is.
He will be the prodigal son one day, though, won't he? He'll just turn up and it'll be like, whoa, Sam's back. Anyway, okay. Michael Tuffery. I need to look at what the song is to remind me. Oh, that's right. He did this song. And I'd only ever heard this song by Brooke Benton. It was actually written by Tony Joe White in 1967, the year that I was born. A Rainy Night in Georgia. So Brooke Benton does a brilliant version of it. Really deep, deep voice. I started playing. I thought, this is fantastic. Straight away, I knew, Michael, that I was going to play it on this month's show. I thought, that's it. Because I visit the clubs thinking, I need to queue a few up and line them up for the next show. And it's a big birthday for Michael. We should do the birthdays. Come on, that's why we're ahead of ourselves. Because I've been neglecting my notes. Line them up for the next show. I'm listening to myself in the green room on someone else's computer. It's amazing. It's like a loop back, I think they call it. You enjoy yourself, John. Right. So I've got a couple of things. I've got a couple of things to mention. He looks like a naughty schoolboy now.
He is.
I'm going to mention my latest CD. This is my listener now. This is what I'm currently listening to. The Browns. Still the same. And I've got to say, the songs, because it's a big love story with the Browns. And it's a love story that's taken years and years and years to come about. It's really lovely. It's lovely. I love your voices. I think they just work so well together. And this has been produced by the fabulous Mr. Tom Evans. Oh. The Tom Evans.
Who? Lovely.
And this is my opportunity to mention my folk crush. Sue, Lynn loves it when I do this. Sue Graves. Because Tom Evans also, I believe, produced Sue's last album. Which is Autumn Gold. I'm getting yeses from everyone else. I'm just rubbish at remembering. But
I know, because I was there.
I'd just like to confirm whether I'm telling the truth or not. But yeah. So, really nice album from the Browns. I think they had a launch party yesterday. So it's only just been released. If you contact Annie Brown or Vern Brown or The Browns on Facebook, I'm sure you can arrange to get a copy.
Yeah.
It's really, really lovely.
And, of course, they will be at Borsbridge.
They're going to be at Borsbridge.
So they'll bring some with them.
You can say it as many times as you
Thanks.
Like.
Thanks.
Because we're all going to be there. We're
if
all
I get a word
there.
In.
If you get
a
word. Okay. Right, we're going to do the birth. No, we have to do this birthday now because it is Michael Tuffery's birthday tomorrow. Today. And that's the only reason he's listening tonight, because he's having a rest tonight, staying at home. Otherwise, he'd be out gallivanting.
Out gallivanting.
Because it's his birthday tomorrow. So, Michael, happy birthday. And your birthday present is we're going to play your song. Thanks for showing that seat. Oh, Annie Brown's with us. Annie, I love it. It's lovely. It's really good. I think you're a lovely couple. Looking forward to seeing you at
Borsbridge Festival.
Yay, here we go. Right, let's have some love and likes for Mr. Michael Tuffery singing A Rainy Night in Georgia on a rainy night at Borsbridge.
Hopping by my suitcase, trying to find a warm place. Seems I hear your voice calling, it's alright. It's a rainy night in Georgia. Such a rainy night in Georgia. I believe it's raining all over the world. Bags and pussies passing through the night. Distant moaning of a train seems to play a sad refrain to the night. It's a rainy night in Borsbridge. It's a rainy night in Georgia. Raining all over the world. Raining all over the world. How many times I wonder, still comes out the same. No matter how you look at it, think of it, it's life, just gotta play the game. So I take up my guitar to pass the time. Late at night when it's hard to rest, hold your picture to my chest and I feel fine. It's a
Yeah, it doesn't get a lot better than that. That was outstanding, Michael Tuffery. Absolutely fantastic. Yeah, all very impressed. And now that I've played the video on the FolkOclock Show, I'll make it available so you can stick it on your own YouTube channel if you want to, or not. But anything I record, I let people have. For anyone who was listening, you could hear Hillary.
Yeah,
you could hear Hillary at the beginning. I think Hillary either likes that song a lot or likes Michael a lot, because there was definitely a bit of girly giggling going on. yeah, fantastic, Michael. Really, really good. Michael's going to the Chessington World of Adventure tomorrow for his birthday.
Oh.
Michael, you're 21, not you're 21, not 12. Flipping out, Chessington World of Adventure.
Bless him.
Good luck to you.
Yeah,
good luck.
To your boat.
Amazing, yeah. Whoa. Fantastic. Kevin Bull's with us. Good evening, Kevin. Yeah, that was fantastic. Really chuffed to bits with that. So, I'm going to deliberately keep her waiting. It's the raffle next. When she's ready, I'm going to start talking. Let's have the birthdays. Michael Tuffery, 27th of April tomorrow. Genuine happy
Excuse
birthday.
Excuse me.
So,
it's very important that I mention that today...
Oh, hold on. I'll give you a microphone.
Today? Well, I should... I promised her I'd mention it.
Hold on.
Here I am on the beautiful shores.
No, that's not what we want. That's what we want.
I wanted to... No, I promised somebody very special that I would mention today to you all that today is Emily's 17th birthday. I cannot believe it. Emily of Emily's Song is now 17.
Oh. Where does the time go?
Where does it go?
Who knows?
Of course, I'm dirty snacking now that she's distracted me.
She just stuffed his face with nuts.
Emily, and they're hot as well, they make me cough. Emily, of course, is Lynn's granddaughter.
Yes.
And there's a beautiful song about Emily. Right, Mike Griffith Ward from the Virtual Folk Club. His birthday on the 28th. Ali McNamara from Ready Folk, Danny's wife, Ali, is on the 30th of April. Charles Gustafson.
Oh.
We like Charles.
Yeah.
Charles's birthday on the 1st of May. Paul Nunk Gillam has got a Star Wars birthday. May the 4th be with you.
And I know someone with that.
Star Wars birthday for Paul Nunk Gillam. Julie Wiggly on the 9th of May. That's as far as I got. It would have been my dad's birthday on the 3rd of May, but he's no longer with us, so love you, Dad. Right. Right, we are going to hear... How many L's can we think of? The lovely...
Lascivious.
Lascivious.
Languid.
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 Lusty.
Lusty.
Luscious.
Yes.
Lynn. Reynolds. Hold on before you... And she's going to explain the raffle rules... Come in, the lovely Lynn.
Hello, everybody. Yes, I'm very sorry, but it's me again. Unfortunately, Sam, well, as we've mentioned, I mean, I think we should just, you know...
Sacked.
Sack him, because once again, he's not with us. So I'm sorry to disappoint you ladies, but I will give him a good thrashing if I do see him.
He'll be back next week.
Down, boys, really. I can't tell you what I have to put up with when I come in here.
He's on his way. He's just texted me.
Just stop. So, so yes, I've got the raffle prize here, and you know the usual rules. But today, slightly different, because I'm also going to throw in two tickets, because they're no good giving one.
Exactly.
Because people want to bring a friend or a partner. So I'm going to throw in two tickets for Borsbridge this year. So even if you've already got tickets, if you win, give them to your friends. That's the idea. Spread the word and make sure everybody comes, because we want to make lots of lovely money for the festival and for MS. So here's the raffle prize. So in order to win the raffle tonight, I want you to give me, I don't know, some comments about the festival. How many of you know, actually, how many years I've done it now? Does anybody know? How many years the festival has actually run?
Not enough.
Not enough.
That's right.
But, you know, if anyone manages to put that in their little comment, then that might just, you know, lean towards you as the winner. So see what you can do.
Is it a special prize or an extra prize?
This
is it one big prize or is it...
One big prize. Two tickets and a bottle of Prosecco.
Ooh,
all right, so see you in a minute. Let's see who wins.
It's a hell of an offer. I'm sure we'll get you exactly... Trumpet voluntary.
Sorry about that, yeah.
Right. We're going to hear from... So, I like... Stop messing. So, I like to play a song from the local clubs. Ready Folk. We've had Ready Folk. We've had the Boars Bridge Sessions. We've had the Windmill. John C. Stannard was at the Windmill. And now we're going to have a video from Poppy's Folk Club. And I must mention that Poppy's Folk Club is next on the 10th of April, which is a Wednesday. It's always on a...
Could be in May as well.
So, say again.
Could be in May.
It is. It's because it's April now, isn't it?
Yes.
I wasn't going to mention that.
So,
nurse.
Yes.
More tablets.
The adjudicator has kicked in and we... the next Poppies is on the 10th of May, which is a Wednesday. And Felix and Kathy are on holiday. They're driving back from Birkenhead that day.
Birkenhead?
They're in Ireland, across the sea to Ireland. They're coming back to Birkenhead. And they're going to drive... I tried posh. It didn't work, did it? No, it didn't work. You know, God loves a try.
Nice
right.
Try.
Yeah, but it's Poppies on the 10th of May. And it's a singer's night. It's not a guest night, so you can all... but you've got to put your name down with Felix and Kathy because they've got a list. You're on enough lists, John. Right.
Yeah.
We're going to hear from the bosses of the Windmill, Gary and Sherryl Payne, performing at Poppy's. That's good, isn't it?
Yeah.
And while it's playing, I'm going to do some more dirty snacking. Let's have some love and likes. Remember the raffle. You've got to put... If you don't comment, Lynn can't pick a winner. Let's have some love and likes for Gary and Sherryl Payne performing a song called Cypress Hills, which was written by John Reichman and Susan Crowe. John Reichman has performed at the Windmill. He's
he
a
has.
Mandolin player.
Yep.
Really good. Well, he wrote this song with a lady called Susan Crowe. Let's have some love and likes.
Thank you.
Sherryl Payne, Cypress Hills. Hills or trees? Cypress Hills.
Cypress Hills.
At Poppy's Folk Club. Right. Before we find out who is the winner of this week's raffle, if anybody remembers last month, our longest ever listener was all the way from Australia.
Oh.
Clive Handy.
Oh, yeah.
Now, Clive did a video, because while he was out there, he convinced his family, you'll see in the video, he convinced his family to put a little band together and play some instruments. And he sent me the video and asked me, would I play it? Of course I will. So while this plays, I thought we could have a little competition. Not a competition, but what I'd like everybody to do, for those of you who are listening and willing, can you all put where you are at the moment? Just one comment, like Bristol or, you know, California or whatever. Just a comment. And all post it while this is playing so we can see where everybody's from. Fabulous. We're going to listen to Clive Handy in Australia with his family in the front room playing all sorts of instruments. Let's have some love and likes for Clive and co. Come on.
Yeah.
Clive Handy, you're a star.
It's all that kangaroo dance.
Exactly. But there was a desperate shortage of cheap speed and cider in that village that evening. And I don't know whether it's Clive's son or Clive's son-in-law, but he's proved that you cannot play the didgeridoo and laugh at the same time. So I don't know if you noticed, but he was giggling a lot and he was struggling on that old didgeridoo. Anyway, Clive, really good, and really appreciate you tuning in all the way from Australia. Now, look at that. We've had some people responding. Right, I'm going to call them out. Lynne, we'll get to you. You look
yeah,
for a winner.
Yeah, that's fine. I'll just sit here.
You look for a winner. You sit there looking good. Right, yeah, okay. I'm going to call them out. Mossingen, Germany, Doris Riebe. Jean Orford, brilliant. I've never heard of the place. Colin Bailey, early. Alison Humphreys, we know you. Alison Humphreys, all the way from Gabriel Island, Canada.
Ooh.
Michael Tuffery, Bracknell, not quite so glamorous. Berkshire, California, Sally Brooke. John Quinn, the mighty Quinn from Crowthorne. Hillary, living room in Leatherhead, Surrey. Posh.
Yeah,
posh.
Living room.
Yeah, Leatherhead. Yeah.
It's got a bow window.
I've been to Hillary's. It's a beautiful place. Jutta is from Herrenberg in Germany. My mum's from Halsall in West Lancashire. Annie Lendon's in Reading. Diane Tassie is in West Sussex. The Gillies are in Forest Hill, London. Ooh. David Edgington, Lanzarote, John Ive, Fleet. John, I know you are. You're sitting next to me. John Ives from Fleet at the posh end. Anna Bass is from Great Bardfield. Jean Orford, Crosby, Liverpool, where I grew up. Woohoo! What else have we got here? That's it. We're done. Thank you, everybody. It's good. It's good to know, isn't it? Yeah, where everybody's from.
Oh, Annie says good night, everyone. Annie Brown.
Oh, Annie Brown. Annie. Yeah. Lovely CD.
Yeah.
Lovely CD. And if we don't see you before, we'll see you at Balls Bridge.
And I think Jan Moncrief has sneezed because she says, Achna Carrie.
Hold on a minute. Oh, that's right. Yeah, no, I can't pronounce that. Loch Lochy. She lives on Loch Lochy.
Yeah, she says it's Achna Carrie.
Yeah, exactly. Bless you. Dave Hunter's in Eastbourne.
Yeah, sorry about that, Steve.
Berkeley, Berkshire. Berkeley, Berkshire is in Berkeley, Berkshire. Not Berkshire, Berkeley. Oh, I see. You're right. Sorry, Anna, I said it wrong. You're in Berkeley. Isn't there a university or something posh there?
Yeah. California.
Yeah,
yes, not Ace. Right, I need to do some dirty snack. Cam Brown's at Wisley, Surrey. I've been to Cameron's house. Dave Hunter, Eastbourne. Right, we need to... I Loch Lochy. Right. Let's crack on because we were ahead of ourselves and we're probably behind now.
Oh, I wonder why.
Let's find out from the lovely Lynne Reynolds, who is this week's raffle winner? Come in, Lynne.
Well, I have to say, we have three people who knew how many Balls Bridge festivals we've had. Jan Moncrief said that she thinks it's been running for 14 years. That is correct, but of course I did miss a couple. One, because I thought I'd have a year off, and then we had the dreaded Big C. So I'm just pressing some buttons on this bit of equipment that belongs to Joe McBurney with some very, very lewd pictures on it, I have to say, for this time of night. I tell you, he looks probably better with clothes on, but never mind.
Rubbish.
Is his phone sticky?
So let me just see what comes up. Oh, hang on. Yes, and the winner of, and I'm very, very pleased because I have not seen this person for a long time, but the winner of a lovely bottle of Prosecco and two tickets to Boar's Bridge, worth £70.
£70. Yay.
Is the lovely Annie Lennon.
Annie Lennon.
I was going to say Annie Lennox.
She can win as well.
So well done, Annie, and I hope to see you soon. Let's hope you can come over. Otherwise, I'll come and deliver them to you.
And just before you finish, can you award John with his bottle?
Oh,
because he's a previous winner.
Could you take this, you know, this sticky item off me?
Rubbish.
So, John, how would you like me to present this to you? Would you like to come over here?
I'll come over here.
And I'll present it to you like this.
Thank you. And I will receive it like this. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Right, I'm done.
Yeah, let's quickly get them off camera. Hello, Lynne. Right. Fabulous. Annie Lennon, you've won yourself a bottle of fizz and two tickets to Boar's Bridge. So, if you come to Boar's Bridge, because it's free now, you can pick up your bottle of fizz.
Yeah.
At Boar's Bridge. Let me write your name down here. Annie Lennon. Well done, Annie. And it's they're weekend tickets, aren't they?
They're for a whole weekend.
They're weekend tickets. So you could either go for the whole weekend or just on one of the days. But it'll be fabulous. Right. Super, we've done the raffle, we've plugged Boar's Bridge, we've eaten the crisps.
Those nuts were hot.
Chewed on the nuts.
I'm going to invite someone else next time. My folk crush, Sue Graves, she's a clean cut girl.
Not if I come as well.
No, attend. Right, we're going to... So we've had the raffle, I didn't even know where I ought to. Ah, right. I'm going to hand over to my good friend, Mr. John Ive, over, as he says in the posh end of Fleet, to introduce Act Number 7. Come in, Mr. John Ive.
Thanks, Joe. And, my pleasure to introduce the first of the acts from the studio this evening. And the first act is Colin Bailey. Now, I assume that many of you know Colin very well. I didn't know him too well, but it's been a real pleasure working with him, doing some recordings, but also for him to prepare this special presentation exclusively for the FolkOclock evening. So Colin tells me that he's also an actor, as well as a very proficient musician, which was news to me. And for those of you who don't know, he does his own songs, writes his own songs, original compositions. He has a Scottish heritage, so he does some Scottish traditional songs, and he tells me he throws in some covers as well. What particularly interests me about Colin is that he's working on, I think, what he calls songs of biography, which is basically songs about people, relating stories about people. And that really is what I enjoy as well in terms of music. I think people who do that well, and Colin certainly does it very well, it's a real pleasure to listen to those kind of songs. So I'm going to hand you over to Colin, and he's going to entertain you with two songs. Colin, come on in.
Thank you. This song is a biographical number about one of my ancestors, my great-grandfather, who spent most of his working life out on the whaling ships in the North Sea. And he survived 6 shipwrecks. He had an interesting life, and I try to tell his story in 5 verses here. So this is dedicated to him, and it's called The Whaling Man. Lad of 15 left his home like father and uncles before. Through sail and steam they braved the seas, rugged whalers all. Ne'er the same when he left dry land, works the decks with his 2 bare hands, learning the trade soon as he can to be a whaling man. To be a whaling man. Years on in a sailing craft, Emma by her name. She's turned to a steamer for the trip, but cursed by the engine strain. In Davis Strait, 3 weeks from home, first mate yells, "Man, safety boats!" Leave the ship for the icy floes. It's a game of the whaling man. It's a game of the whaling man. Picked up by a vessel, Norway's best, they're almost sunk again. Whole voyage home, all pumps were worked by the tired and weary men. Rescued again back at Peterhead, thank the Lord, not a sailor's dead. But he keeps going out to see his family fed. That's the life of a whaling man. That's the life of a whaling man. Years in the whaling game, through storms and wrecks survive. Settles down in a safe land job, though barely feels alive. When he can, he's out in a boat again, on Taybridge night, blowing gale force 10. He'll search for bodies with the trawler men. He's still a whaling man. He's still a whaling man. The soul in great gold age lives in Africa's sun, but climate fair doesn't fare him well. He's back again in months. Not a stick of furniture to his name. Joburg's losses, Dunbar's gain. He'll shun the sun for Lothian's reign. For he's a whaling man. Thank you. And for my second song, another biographical one, about one of my heroes, the gentleman who started the caving business in the Cheddar Gorge. And his wife was the first person to start a cheese enterprise down there. It's also the place where the oldest intact human remains are, Cheddar Man. And they all get a mention in this song, which is called In the Gorge. Richard Coxgough, he's retired from the sea. The schoolroom, he mastered a fortune from tea. But pioneer spirit in measure unbound spurred him through later years to a fate underground. Old uncle, his tutor, there was gain in the trade, with folk ever willing to follow him where he bade. Neither age nor infirmity held Richard back. With a pick and a shovel, who would stand in his track? In the gorge he's made a stand, cutting through the rock his plan. On his trail, six sons and his wife lend a hand, till he finds the Cheddar Man. Stalagmites, giant columns rose before him in turns, as he broke through the limestone his wages to earn. Light barely a flicker, joints worn by the strain. There was scarcely an hour he'd not flinch from the pain. In the gorge he's made a stand, cutting through the rock his plan. On his trail, six sons and his wife lend a hand, till he finds the Cheddar Man. Well, the cave is dark, but a vision he could glean. Has opened up a world that once had been. From the past, his family's future now is seen. 7 years in the cavern and a public in thrall. Gough by now could surely bid adieu to it all. But the next and the next cave would beckon him in. Cathedral and temple, God's praises to sing. In the gorge he's made a stand, cutting through the rock his plan. On his trail, six sons and his wife lend a hand, till he finds the Cheddar Man. In the gorge he's made a stand, cutting through the rock his plan. On his trail, six sons and his wife lend a hand, till he finds the Cheddar Man. Till he finds the Cheddar Man. Till he finds the Cheddar Man. Thank you. Thank you.
Yay, Colin Bailey. Colin Bailey of the Bailey Beat. Fantastic, Colin, thank you. Beautifully recorded by Mr. John Ive.
Yes, very nice.
Very good. Like the new backdrop, John. Red, that was good, that works. Sue Graves is in the house. Folk Crush arrived.
About time.
Hi, Sue.
Better late than never.
Yeah, exactly.
You've been mentioned already, Sue.
Yes.
I hope you're well. Lovely lovely to be here. A bit late. No, apologies. Cool.
Sorry,
you're here now.
Mum will be provided. Okay.
Nice comments coming in for Colin. Well done, Colin Bailey of the Bailey Beat. Great stuff, Colin, by the Gillies. Two wonderful songs. Sally likes it. Fantastic. And we've done a lot of dirty snacking. It's my night off, you see. I eat lettuce all week. I don't really, but...
Do you?
Know, that's what I say.
What's
no,
all this?
No, it's terrible. That's my holiday.
She's going to say, lettuce is obviously very fattening.
Yeah. Thank you for that. Anyway, that's why we just have a shoulders and above shot. Anyway, so, yeah, wonderful. Thank you, Colin Bailey. We're going to have our next live act this evening. I don't expect she even realises, because she doesn't look like she's ready. She's frantic now.
It was all that notice you didn't give her.
Yeah. She's, yeah.
Yeah.
Three quarters of the way down a bottle of red. Oh, we're ready. Yeah, we're ready now. Okay. I'm delighted. And I say it every time, but genuinely I am. Doris, I'm really looking forward to seeing our next act is Doris Riebe from Germany. And Doris will be coming to Borsbridge. I'm assuming. It's a fair assumption. So I will see you. And remind me, Doris, before... You need to remind me up front, because I will forget. I'm going to buy you a bottle of the King's Ginger.
Oh, it's nice.
Yeah. Everybody likes a fancy liquor.
Yeah.
So, stop laughing.
Why? It is
the King's Ginger. It's,
yeah.
Have you not tasted it?
You made
oh,
me
no,
have
you should try it.
Earlier.
It's fantastic. Right.
Very nice.
We're going to go all the way to Germany, and we're going to have a couple of songs from Doris. Doris, I'm chuffed a bit you've come back to sing for us. Let's have some special Folk O'Clock love and likes for the delightful Doris Riebe. Come on, Doris.
Woo!
Thanks a lot. Thanks for inviting me, Joe. It's great to be on the Folk O'Clock show. And yeah, as you can see, I picked up my 12th string. And a little story around why I chose this first song. End of March, my boss had a party for his retirement. He invited everyone, but had no idea who would come. When I arrived with my guitar case, he asked, "Oh, you'd play us some songs?" I said, "Oh, well, we'll see." Sure. I played some songs, but he had no idea what. First, I played Country Roads, accompanied by his wife, who sings in a gospel choir. It sounded really, really lovely. For the second song, I wrote my own lyrics to "Don't Worry, Be Happy." It's about my story with my boss. For the third song, another colleague wrote personal lyrics to a in Germany well-known song by the band Truck Stop. And the whole team and some more colleagues sang the song for him. It was great fun, and our boss was touched because he didn't expect something like this at all. The song I'd like to play now is the original Truck Stop song from 1977. It's about a trucker driving in the north of Germany on a cold winter, snowy winter night, just looking for some good country music. I'm explaining this because the song is in German. Es ist schon fast nach Mitternacht, mein Tag ist längst vorbei. Mir fallen gleich die Augen zu, verdammte Fahrerei. Der NDR bringt Tanzmusik, ich krieg nichts anderes rein. Das geht so durch bis 6 Uhr früh, ich glaub, ich schlaf gleich ein. Ich möchte so gern Dave Dudley hören, Hank Snow und Charlie Bright. Ein richtig schönen Country-Song, doch AFN ist weit. Ich möchte so gern Dave Dudley hören, Hank Snow und Charlie Bright. Ein richtig schönen Country-Song, doch AFN ist weit. Schneesturm auf der Autobahn und vor mir keine Spur. Ich seh die blauen Schilder kaum und ahn die Fahrbahn nur. Drum nehm ich mir mein Funkgerät, Kanal 410. An alle, hier spricht Gunter G., ich hab da ein Problem. Ich möchte so gern Dave Dudley hören, Hang Snow und Charlie Bright. Ein richtig schönen Country-Song, doch AFN ist weit. Ich möchte so gern Dave Dudley hören, Hank Snow und Charlie Bright. Ein richtig schönen Country-Song, doch AFN ist weit. Ich halt am nächsten Rasthof an und leg ne Pause ein. Ich schlaf am Tisch, der Kellner kommt und sagt, was soll's denn sein? Ich schau ihn an und weiß genau, der Mann wird's nicht verstehen. Ich möchte weder Milchkaffee, noch möchte ich schwarzen Tee. Ich möchte nur Dave Dudley hören, Hank Snow und Charlie Bright. Ein richtig schönen Country-Song, doch AFN ist weit. Ich möchte nur Dave Dudley hören, Hank Snow und Charlie Bright. Ein richtig schönen Country-Song, doch AFN ist weit.
Yay!
Woo! Very nice.
Thank you.
How do we say in German? Good.
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 Good. Good. Sehr gut.
Sehr gut, ja.
Oh, we're good at German.
Good.
I'm sure you understood every word. For example, Dave Dudley, something like this, Charlie Bright, Hank Snow. Okay, and my second song is the last song from my first EP. It's my favorite one on this EP, and it's called Ready for the Times to Get Better. It's been a too long time with no peace of mind, and I'm ready for the times to get better. It's been a too long time with no peace of mind. I'm ready for the times to get better. I've got to tell you, I've been wrecking my brain, hoping to find a way out. I've had enough of this continual rain. Changes are coming, no doubt. It's been a too long time with no peace of mind. I'm ready for the times to get better. You seem to want from me what I cannot give. I feel so lonesome at times. A dream that I wish I could live. It's burning holes in my mind. It's been a too long time with no peace of mind. I'm ready. It's been a too long time. No peace of mind. I'm ready for the times to get better. It's been a too long time with no peace of mind. And I'm ready for the times to get better.
Lovely. Yay.
Yay. Lovely.
And back to you, Joe.
Doris. Yes. Thank you, Doris. All the way from Germany.
Jolly good.
Love it. You can relax now, Doris. You can have a nice glass of red.
Glass of whiskey.
And of course, is it? Are you an hour ahead of us, Doris?
Yes.
So it's late.
Oh.
It's very much appreciated. I'd be in bed by now normally. What's the time? No, not quite. I go at 10 o'clock.
I go at 9.
10 o'clock. Go to bed. No, no, sometimes I go early and just lie there looking at me phone.
looking at me phone.
You're terrible.
It's not me,
if anybody would like to come and join me, a clean person would like to come and join me in the studio 1 week, it would be very much appreciated. Smutty. Right. Super, Doris. Fantastic. Thank you very much. And lovely German song. I did recognise some of the names, clearly, but other than that, Michael.
I can't read that.
No, no, I can't. I'm pressing Google Translate. Excellent.
Ah.
Flipping heck. He's like a native.
Oh, he is. Is there no end to Michael Tuffery's talents?
Yeah, the end tomorrow at Chessington World of Adventure when he goes on the Big Dipper. Michael, I'd be careful if I were you. Don't go on those mad things. Anyway, right. And Doris, you sang a German song. Fantastic. Absolutely love it. Right, we've had a good time tonight. We've done a lot of dirty snacking. We've had some good live acts. And time-wise, we're doing really well. I think we are in with half a chance of finishing at 10 o'clock. We shall see. Our next act this evening, we call him the chairman of the board. I'm not quite sure where we got that from. Because when Sam and Peter and I started going to the folk club and we sat at the back like naughty boys eating crisps and chatting, Steve Donnelly turned up and he looks like a chairman of the board. He's got that look about him, hasn't he? Like, you know, he's the boss man, chairman of the board. It's just, that's the look. It's a good look. It's not an insult.
You need to go to Specsavers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, he's with us tonight live. We've dragged him all the way back from the Alps. Is it Switzerland? Wengen?
Wengen, yeah.
Wengen, yeah. Yeah,
nice place.
If you've delivered all the milk tray. Once your job's done, you can go then, can't you?
Very true.
Delivered the milk tray, I can go home now.
It's Toblerone, actually.
Toblerone.
That's another story.
But they've changed something with Toblerone, haven't they? Can't they show the mountain or they can't do something on...
It's the packaging has the Matterhorn.
Oh, that's it.
But the chocolate's no longer made in Switzerland or in that canton, so they're having to repackage it.
Then. Really?
Yeah, it's a Swiss fruit, isn't it? Really?
Dear me.
God.
Sorry, we're having a chat with Steve Donnelly. I'm going to bring him on camera because he's going to entertain us and sing us a couple of songs. Steve, I'm delighted you're with us. Let's have some love and likes, Mr. Steve Donnelly.
Hi, everybody. Great to be here tonight. The goings-on in this studio, well, I will close the book on that. Anyway, I'm going to sing a couple of songs. One is my own, but I'm going to start off with a classic song, which I've known for years. Never really got round to learning and singing, but the words are as pertinent now as they were when they were written, 50-odd years ago. You'll know it, so join in at home, please. Hello, darkness, my old friend. Come to talk with you again. Like a vision softly sweeping, heard my heart when I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted in my brain still remains in the sound of silence. In restless dreams I walked alone, narrow streets of cobblestone. Neath the halo of a street lamp, I turned my collar to the cold and damp. When my eyes were stabbed by the flash of a neon light that split the night and touched the sound of silence. And in that naked light I saw
10,000 people, maybe more. People talking without speaking, people hearing without listening, people writing songs that voices never shared, 'cause no one dared disturb the sound of silence. Fool said, I do not know. The silence like a cancer grows. Hear my words that I might teach you. Take my arms that I might reach you. But my words like silent raindrops fell and echoed in the wells of silence. And the people bowed and prayed to the neon gods they made. And the sign flashed out its warning in the words that it was forming. And the sign said, the words of the prophet are written on the subway walls and tenement halls and in the sound of silence. Fool said, I do not know. The silence like a cancer grows. Hear my words that I might teach you. Take my arms that I might reach you. But my words, like silent raindrops, fell and echoed in the wells of silence. Great accompany from the guys in the studio. Yes, indeed. This next song is a song of mine. We've touched on it, the subject this evening about losing people. It's been a torrid 3, 4, 5 years. But when people pass away, we lose them, but we never forget them. And then some days you feel that they're almost still with us. It goes like this. In the quiet of the evening, in the early morning light, as the day is dawning and chasing away the night, you're walking down a long and winding road. You're hoping that somebody will help you with your load. Well, I'll be there, yes, I'll be there. I've been walking right beside you, to guard you and to guide you. I'll be there, yes, I'll be there. Can you feel my arms around me? I'll be there. They say the darkest star is just before the dawn. When you're feeling lonesome and you really can't go on, but I want you to know you're not alone. 'Cause nothing lasts forever. Life goes on and on. Yes, one day you will turn around, find that I am gone. But my love for you will last a million years. So dry your eyes, come on, wipe away your tears, 'cause I'll be there, I'll still be there. I'll be walking right beside you, I'll be there. Nothing lasts forever. Life goes on and on. Yeah, one day you will turn around and find that I am gone. But my love for you will
last a million years. So dry your eyes, come and wipe away the tears, 'cause I'll be there, I will be there. I'll be walking right beside you, to guard you and to guide you. I'll be there, yes, I'll be there. Can you feel my love surround you? You'll be there. Can you feel my love surround you? I'll be there.
Is that new? Came off the press last week or so.
Yeah, nice. New one. Beautiful.
Lovely.
Thank you, Steve Donnelly. New one. I thought I hadn't heard it. What a beautiful song. And of course, a classic Simon and Garfunkel. Yeah, and everybody's saying they're singing along.
Good. Yes. Excellent.
Brilliant. Thanks for coming back, Steve. Good to see you.
Great to be here.
Safe off the mountain. did you get the same? Because I went skiing this year for the first time in 5 years. And it was hard work. And on that last day, when you that last, you think, I made it. I'm still alive.
I always, at the end of my ski season, go to the top of the mountain, thank the gods.
Yeah, cool.
And hope I get down before breaking another leg. But there you go.
Yeah, exactly. No, it's good to have you back. You sounded fantastic. Thank you very, very much. Right, we're on for our final act of this evening. And I'm delighted. I'm not going to introduce these guys, but it's a first time on the FolkOclock Show. I'm going to hand you over to my co-presenter, Mr. John Ive, who's going to introduce our... What's the last act?
Penultimate.
Penultimate act. Is that the last one?
The last one.
The next one before the last one.
Well, you were the penultimate.
I was the penultimate.
Yeah, Steve.
This is the last one.
Top
of the shop. Top of the shop. Come in, Mr. John Ive.
Well, I'm glad you got that sorted out, whether or not the penultimate or the ultimate, I think, is a better word, possibly. So it was a real pleasure meeting up with the Gillies, and that's who we have for you now. I suspect some of you know the Gillies. As we heard earlier, they come from Forest Hill, but I think they do get out to some of the folk clubs, maybe Twick Folk or somewhere. So I'm sure some of you do know them. They were introduced to me by Gianfranco Novarino, who's been on the show before. And I'm really pleased he did introduce me. They're kind of hard to categorize, but they have been said to be have a hint of Americana. And I think that's pretty much right. I'm sure I think they may be online right now. So if I get this wrong, I'm sure they'll correct it in the comments. They write their own songs, and we're going to hear from Susan Turner and Mark Evans. They're the duo. Susan plays a four-string guitar, and that was new for me. It really is a four-string guitar, and I'm not sure if that's very well known or very popular, but it works fantastically in their duo. In their recordings, they add other instruments, and I think Mark also plays other instruments. They've produced four albums. The most recent, which fantastic album, Masonry and Nails, is I think is their latest. And if you like what you hear, and I'm sure you will, you can go to the Gillies Music for more about the Gillies. So less from me and more from the Gillies. Here you go.
Thank you. The first song we're going to do is called Hard Times, and it's a song written by Gillian Welsh and Dave Rawlings. There was a captain then, he used to plow and sing. He loved that mule, and the mule loved him. My sweet old girl, in her own sweet time. So come on, you Asheville boys, turn up your old-time noise and kick till the dust comes up from the cracks in the floor.
Very much. Okay, the next song we're going to sing is one of our own songs, and it's called Light Bulbs and Chemicals. And when we write our own songs, we sort of co-write together, but we sort of object write. So this song was written while sitting in our living room about things in our living room, and we tend to collect quite a lot of odd things and have a lot of very rusty things and Madonnas, and I collect lots of Madonnas. No reason other than I quite like them. So our living room is full of things like that. And then it sort of ended up being this song, which is quite was quite random, but it's quite an interesting... it's quite interesting how things come out of nothing. Give me a G. My guitar's very old and it goes out of tune very quickly. Okay, ready then? Thank you.
rain has taken its toll, but you are still there beneath it all. You said you had a fear of ghosts walking the edges wearing thin. If our love yous are still there after all this time, if I could, I would move and get back on this train. You pull me in again, it twists and burns. With your secret kisses, it caught me unaware. Sometimes things can't be learned. Like some godforsaken refrain, and I can't get back on this train. Crystallized and brittle white. You always hum so gently, so quietly it almost can't be heard. If you're lost, then I'm lost in this town, and I can't get back on this train. No, I can't get back on this train. Thank you very much.
Yay! The Gillies. Mm-hmm. I love the vibe. It reminds me a little bit about... There's a guy in America called Beck, and I've got an album of his. And I only know this one album, but it's got that sort of cool... I think like a West Coast-y kind of... I don't know. The Gillies. I think it sounded great. I don't know what genre you kind of fit yourself in, but good. I love the tenor guitar and the Martin, the Gibson. I like the not, you've got a fancy Gibson, haven't you?
I do.
And I like the non-fancier, you know, the sort of more... J45. Is that what it is, J45?
Sorry, is it J?
I don't know.
J's.
Yeah, lovely songs, lovely instruments, beautifully delivered. Thank you very, very much. The Gillies. And... Although I'm still talking now, we did finish at 10 o'clock.
Hooray!
So all I'm going to say is all of the thank yous, special thanks to all of our great performers. Let's have a rundown, we always do. The Berries recorded at Ready Folk. Conor Reynolds recorded over at IveTech Media. John Tanner live in the studio.
Yay!
Thank you, John.
Thank you.
John C Stannard recorded over at the Windmill Acoustic Sessions. Michael Tuffery recorded over at Boar's Bridge. Gary and Sherryl Payne recorded at Poppy's. Clive Handy from Australia. Colin Bailey recorded over at IveTech Media. Doris Riebe live from Germany. Thank you, Doris. Chairman of the board, Steve Donnelly. Thank you, Steve. Sorry about the shoes falling from the sky. It was like a chicken licking moment, wasn't it? Falling from the sky. And our headline act for this evening, the Gillies. Thank you very much. We also need to thank the FolkOclock team. I'm Joe. Thank you, everybody, for joining us. Raffle. It says master. We've got to change this now because it is officially. Come on, say. We can't see. There's... Lynne Reynolds, remember Boar's Bridge. We'll see you there, Annie Lendon.
And remember Boar's Bridge this Friday night as well, which I forgot to mention. It is Boar's Bridge this Friday night.
Boar's Bridge sessions.
Come along.
Very good. Bring your instrument, play along. Really good. Where are we? And, of course, Mr. John Ive.
Hey.
The quiz. All of the music. And generously recording people in his studio and donating money to the... come on, John.
Musicians.
Help musicians.
Help musicians.
Thank you. Help me, John. Help musicians. That's it. And, of course, our winners this evening, the raffle, Michael Tuffery. No, the quiz was Michael Tuffery and the raffle, Annie Lendon. Tickets to Ballsbridge, that can't be bad at all, can it?
I think we should thank Lottie for picking Michael Tuffery.
Yeah, Lottie. Well done, Lottie.
Yeah.
Lottie, the Folk O'Clock dog. And where are we? And, of course, our wonderful audience. Thank you all very, very much. Where are we now? We're in May. It's not May.
No, it's not May.
We're in April.
April.
And we will have a show in May. So I look forward to seeing everybody in May. The drinks have been free all night. But before you go, please don't... I know, here's the thing.
Yeah.
We need a ladies' version.
Yes, we do.
Of Don't Forget Your Empty Glasses.
Yes.
So... if all the ladies do their own individual bits of this, I'm sure if you send it to John Ive or myself, we'll put the video together for you.
Yes.
So we can replace this one that the boys do. Anyway, having said that, so somebody needs to get it organised.
Yeah, I'll do it.
Be safe and don't forget your empty glasses.
Don't forget your empty glasses.
Take your glasses to the bar.
Don't forget your empty glasses.
Take your glasses
to the bar.
Take your glasses. Take your glasses. Take your glasses to the bar.
Such a very pretty place to be, down on Hampton Green. Down to Hampton Green we'll go, down to Hampton Green. Such a very pretty place to be, down on Hampton Green. Church of old Saint Theodore welcomes everyone. Father leads the singing, hymns for old and young. Lunchtime finds him at the railway bell with his beer and ploughman's. Different songs and different tales to tell from all the folks around him. Such a very friendly place to be down on Hampton Green. Down to Hampton Green we'll go, down to Hampton Green. Such a very friendly place to be down on Hampton Green. Peaceful place to be down on Hampton Green.